to the drummer. In the city of lights, yeah. In the backstreet balls, in the neon lights, yeah. Well, I heard the thunder, I can feel the rain.
My name is Melissa Covert, and I am Mike Covert's wife of 26 years. Well, as we're in regards to being a fireman, I think I kind of have a different take on it because I grew up with my dad being on the job for 33 years, and so it was all I knew. Just like it was whenever I was growing up with dad being gone. Now, my dad had a part-time job that was daytime, whereas he's always flown with Life Air, you know, for 10 years or worked at the fire district. So sometimes it's not just a 24, but a 72 or a 96. And so I think having grown up around that, it helped me to adjust with him being gone. You know, a lot of ladies are scared to sleep at night if their husband's not here, and that's just all we've ever known. If he's home, we've always made sure, you know, the kids might have kids, friends over, spending the night for two or three nights in a row, and then when dad comes home, hey, he's only home for one night, this is family night. And so we've tried to, you know, base what we do here, make a big deal, you know, try to plan things around when he's home. So, but I think, too, I learned from just watching my mom and dad, how to handle things. You don't know how to put it into words, but if it's gonna go wrong, it's gonna be when they're at the station. If the kids are gonna be sick, he's gonna be at work. If the septic's gonna back up, he's gonna be at work. That's just the way it is. And so, I think I kind of had an advantage on, you know, being able to handle that. But you know, you never know. And when you call and you need him right now, they're on a run and can't answer the phone, or you know. You do feel like a single mom at times, and you have to handle everything. You handle doctor's appointments. You handle, you know, all kinds of things that come up with them. And just like we were just talking the other day about how Mikey is grown and doing starting his own thing, but they still call me first. Because through the years of something coming up, it was always call mom because dad might be on a run. Even though he's the head of the house and fully capable when he's here of handling everything, it does kind of seem like you're a single mom and always the one that the kids go to for stuff.
I'm Kinsey Covert. I'm 19. Mike Covert is my dad. I mean, it was hard at times, like, because he did have to miss some stuff, but I never, like, held that against him because I know he's out saving other people's lives. I feel like I grew up a little bit differently than other people just because, not in a bad way, but I feel like I grew up with a different appreciation for family than a lot of others, because if dad was home, like, that was our family night. Like, I would tell my friends, like, sorry, I can't hang out with you, my dad's home. So a lot of people are just like, well, what's the big deal? Like, your dad's home. But when he is gone and when he works 72-hour shifts, it's different. So when he is home, it was always emphasized family time. And I'm super proud of Mikey. It's different. Like, it's kind of bittersweet because I don't know. Mikey's always been, like, he was my first best friend, and he's always been my best friend growing up. So it's different having him gone all the time. Like, my dad, he's always been a fireman. So now that Mikey's out in it, it's different, but I'm super proud of him because I know that that's what he's always, like, always wanted to do. And he's always worked super, super hard to get where he's at. And I know that he loves it. So I'm super proud of him.
My name is Matthew Covert, and I've been Michael Covert's son for the past 14 years.
Because there have been some days that, like, let's say he works a 72. Or let's back up to when he was at Life Air, and he would maybe work a 72. And then he'd come home at 3, and Matthew would be excited for him to be there. And then dad would head upstairs around 5:30 and come down in his flight suit, and Matthew would be like, what? You just got home, and you're leaving again? So I think it kind of all runs together, but there have been times where he worked a stretch and was gone so long that it started to affect the kids, and I'm ready for daddy to be home.
I thought it was pretty cool. I mean, that's my dad working on patients and stuff. I mean, I've always wanted to do that since I was little, and just hearing about them do all this cool stuff, I want to do it too, like save lives and stuff. So
whenever it was time for Dad to go to work, he started this waving, kissing. So anyway, it started this pattern of every time Daddy would go to work, he had to wave, kiss, blow kisses. And then he started this, no, don't go, and then bye. So it turned into, well, I'm going to wave, kiss, no, and goodbye, like he was 2 or 3. Well, he's 14 now, and it's a little, it's been tweaked a little. But every single day when Mike goes to work, doesn't matter if he's doing this, because we homeschool, doesn't matter if he's doing school work or what he's doing, he goes to the door,
such a crick in the neck! Nice to be back, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, where are you from?
Brady Cartwright. I am a firefighter, hoseman, back-end man, whatever you want to call it. I've been on for 6 years, and I'm bid in at number 7 for most of my career. No, you're right. I've swung around and worked at other stations, but this one's different. I knew when I first worked over here that these guys, they actually love each other. You know, they might not come out and say it, but we like being around each other. We hang out off the job. It's a big family. We're like brothers, and we'll mess with each other, make fun of each other. But outside of here, we take up for one another. It's difficult. Sometimes it's, you know, baby's crying and one of them's sick and wife's not feeling well, and I have to leave that and where I'm needed and have to come up here and do a job. It's tough sometimes. We do sacrifice a lot as far as time away from our family, and we miss a lot of events, birthdays, Christmases, Thanksgiving, and they're all doing family fun things, and we're here. This is a 24-hour, 365 job. We're here all the time, and that means being away from your family when you want to be home. So it's tough times. Sometimes, but as a whole, it's a very rewarding job. You never know what you're going to do when you come to work. It's what makes it exciting, what keeps it fun. And it's rewarding to go out and help somebody that really needs it. When they call you, they're having the worst day. And it's a good way to look at it that way. And that you're here to facilitate them, help them, whether it be something small or large. We deal with a little bit of everything. And so when we're home, we're away from our home, and with our second home up here, we're doing our job, but we're with a goal of helping others.
Okay, my name is Devin Cartwright. Brady and I have been married for 7 years. I work at a local elementary school down the street, 2 miles from home. Hagen Hunter is 4.5 years old, and Roman Dean is 7 months old, and he also goes to the little daycare at our church down the street. I mean, I don't really get scared or anything. I did at first, because before the kids came along, because I'd never stayed a single night alone ever. So that took some getting used to. But when the kids came along, really, I'm just so busy with them, tending to them, that I really don't think about it. Plus, we have an alarm, and my dad is like a mile down the road. So, but it is kind of frustrating when something happens and you're here by yourself. You really have to call on family or neighbors or whatever. And we're very close to our neighbors and family, and they help a lot. And it is hard. It's like playing the role of a single mom every other night, basically. And it really makes you appreciate them more, because you realize how much they do help out when they're here. The other night we all got together, the whole crew, and went to Texas Roadhouse, which was really cool because, you know, it was like the fire family, but away from the work setting. So it was nice to just kind of have a relaxing meal and enjoy each other's company. So that was fun, and we definitely should do that more often.
My name's Aaron Naquin. I'm the driver on Engine 7. I've been here for 15 years. I got hired in 2001. I've been at on Engine 7 my whole career. It is rewarding to have your kids look up to you for something like that. You know what I mean? It's I got three kids, and to them it's a big deal when I go. You know, they get sad. I miss a lot of ball games. You know, I miss a bunch. But you know, I mean, it's just part of the deal. It is rewarding to hear my daughter say that. You know, that's good to hear. Which, you know, I mean, it shows. It shows at the house. Whenever I go to leave, they all want to hug me and kiss me. You know, but to hear them say it's a little different.
I'm Avery Naquin, I'm 17, and Aaron Naquin is my dad. It can be hard just because, like, with softball games, he never really got to go to them, or school plays he couldn't really go to, but it made me thankful, like, that he did do that stuff so that I could go to softball tournaments and go to those school plays and be in a private school. I guess it's kind of scary knowing that he's risking his life. Like, every day he leaves home, he's gonna risk his life. But it makes me proud of him knowing, like, that he's going into houses and he's trying to save people and helping the sick people. And it makes me happy, like, that God can use him like that and to touch people's lives. I want to say that I'm thankful for all the firemen and how they risk their lives every day and save other people. And it makes me really proud that my dad's a part of that.
My name's Chris Brown. I'm a captain on the Shreveport Fire Department. I've been at Fire Station Number 7 basically my whole career. I swung and worked at every station, but in 25 and a half years, this is the only station I've ever been assigned to. I worked at every position at this station, worked my way up here. I'm currently the captain on Truck 7 and with my driver, Richard Reynolds. And I was when I was a kid, my dad was a welder. He was a pipeline welder, and I wanted to be my dad. You know, I wanted to be tough and strong like he was, and so I think that's just normal for a son to look up to his dad and want to be whatever he's doing at the time. I don't have any regrets. I still look at this job as a blessing. I'm glad to have it. There are a lot of sacrifices. You know, your friends pick on you about being off all the time. Well, no one thinks about all the times that they're home with their family and we're sleeping up here. But all the sacrifices are worth it because we have a flexible schedule and, you know, everyone's qualified to work in every position. So when Matthew does have a band concert, a ball game or whatever, well, it's so easy to get someone to fill in for you and you can make it. And, you know, being a dad, I've tried to make everything he's ever had, you know, and haven't even missed a Christmas morning in 11 years. And I think that's a great job. You know, a lot of people can't do that. So, you know, I'm fortunate.
My name is Matthew Brown, 11 years old, and I'm Captain Chris Brown's son.
Do you ever get scared with him being on the job? Is when he leaves for work and you're at home, does it make you nervous that he leaves and you know he might be going to a house fire or something at some point?
It doesn't. It used to, but I've got it now.
Tell him why you don't miss me while I'm gone.
Because I know the Lord is with him. Fortunately, I have a mother that takes good care of me. I like that he's a good inspiration to me. It's just always a fun, good time. Get to film the trucks leave when they do. I want to be a firefighter.
My name is Austin Harrell. I'm a firefighter. Station 7. I've been on a little over 2 years now. It's definitely a second family. You can watch behind the scenes. We can't even get a clip done on us because we're goofing off so much. And hey, you know, I'm young enough to call my, they are like brothers. We fish together outside of work together. And when we work up here together, we know everything about each other pretty much. And that helps out a lot. You know, getting along with them because, like you said, in 5 minutes when being in a burning house trying to pull somebody out, and you don't want to hang around people you don't really get along with and then have to go through all that and see all the bad things that we see and have to deal with bad attitudes when you get back to the station. So when you get along with people like we all do, big family, it makes it easier because you can all
laugh and joke. It kind of makes things go a little smoother.
Name's Richard Reynolds, been at Station 7 here for about 17 years, pretty much my whole career. Yeah, you know, was here as a rookie. Of course, we had, with the exception of Captain Chris, a whole different crew. But at first, it was just to work in this area, just like this area, either here or Station 10. And I don't know, just kind of got in where I fit in and stayed here. I hadn't really thought about it that way. It's just something, my dad was a fireman, my uncle was a fireman, I had a cousin on the job. Just, it's what I wanted to do. Unfortunately, you'd spend a lot of time away from your family, you know. It's important to have a, you know, woman that understands, you know. And, you know, some kids that understand too. You're gonna miss birthdays, you have to reschedule stuff, and but it hadn't really been that tough.
Michael Wayne Covert, Sr., Captain, Engine 7 A Shift. I've been on for, working on my 22nd year with Shreveport. You know, when you first get promoted, or you're close to getting promoted, they usually, you're swinging around, you're riding out of class. And my first official shift as a captain, I made captain January 1st, and I was here at Station 7. And it didn't take me long to fall in love with the station, the crew, just everything about this whole just environment. I'd been around, you know, like most guys, I swung around and I've been to a lot of different stations. I've been to paramedic stations and non-paramedic stations, medic unit stations, and this just fit my personality. Yeah, and you know, when you do work, I mean, almost every fireman works a side job. Yeah. But we just do. And, you know, we work two shifts and we put in 48 hours. That already is more than 8 hours in a regular 40-hour work week. And people don't take that into consideration. Well, y'all get to sleep. Yep, really? You ever come hung out at the fire station and see that bell go off all night long? And at 7 o'clock in the morning, you're back up and you're at it again. And you may have gotten a couple hours of sleep. You know, I just said, you know. I just said it. But anyway, back to what I was saying, you know, they think, oh, you get to sleep at the fire station. Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. It's not a guarantee. We mess with each other so much, so often, and yet if something goes down or something goes bad, and we've all found ourselves. I've made mistakes as a captain. I've not made the best decisions every time. Aaron's made a wrong turn before. Brady is just, he's like an airhead sometimes. But they're very confident, and we know that each other are not perfect, but we love each other anyway, and we learn from the mistakes. And it's nice having a solid crew. I don't have to worry about the ladder truck when they're pulling up behind us, whether or not they're going to be in a position to help us if we need it. I don't have to worry about Aaron getting water. I don't have to worry about Brady getting the right equipment. I mean, it's going to happen. It's like a well-oiled machine over here, and it makes my job a whole lot easier.